Hey children, Sai Ram, welcome to EVS class. Students, I hope you all must have practiced the new words. Yes or no, which we have studied in the last period. So today, we are going to start with a new chapter. Okay, it is very easy and simple chapter. Okay, so shall we start? Okay, so first, give me the answer of this question. Why do we need water? Why do we need water? Think for the answer. It's very easy. Why do we need water? Okay, I will give you the answer for this. We need water for drinking, cleaning, cooking, and bathing. Water is the basic need of all living beings. We use water for so many purposes. Without water, a life is impossible. Yes or no? We all need water. We need water for drinking, for cleaning, cooking, for all our daily purpose. For our daily purpose, we need water. Yes or no? Daily we need water for bathing, for washing our clothes, utensils. Yes or no? So water is very important for us. Without water, can we live? No. A life without water is impossible. So kids, today we are going to study a chapter which is based on water. Okay, so our chapter name is water. What is our chapter name? Water. Okay, so let's start. We all need water for different purposes. Plants and animals also need water to live. See, everybody needs water. We also need water. Even animals and plants need water to live. Yes or no? Everyone needs water. Water is very important for us. Animals also need water for drinking. Plants need water. Without water, plants will die. Even animals will also die. Yes or no? Even we cannot survive without water. Yes or no? So, let's see from where we get this water. Okay? Where do we get water from? Where do we get water from? Let's see. The 3/4 of the earth is covered with water. We get water from many sources such as rain, lakes, rivers, waterfalls, seas and oceans. We get water from, what are the sources from where we get water? We get water from rain, lakes, rivers, waterfalls, seas and oceans. Okay? These are the pictures. Can you see the picture? Yes. These are some sources from where we get water. And our earth, 3/4 of the earth is covered with water. Okay? Now, what is the use of water and how we should use water? Let's see. Rain water gets collected in lakes, rivers, ponds and wells. This water is cleaned before it reaches our homes through pipes. We get water through taps in our homes. Yes or no? In earlier time, people used to bring water from well. Yes or no? They used to bring water from well, rivers, lakes. Okay? But nowadays, we are getting water easily. Why? Because we all are having taps. Yes or no? Through pipelines, the water is coming to our house. And once we open the tap, water is coming. Yes or no? So, how we get water? Rainwater gets collected in lakes, rivers, ponds and wells. And this water The rainwater which is collected in rivers, lakes and ponds and wells, all these waters are cleaned before coming to our house. These waters are being filtered. This water is being filtered and then it reaches our house through pipes. Okay. Now, sea and ocean water is salty and cannot be used for drinking and cooking. See kids, ocean and sea water. Ocean and sea water, both these water are very salty. We cannot filter that water and we cannot use that water for drinking and cooking purpose. Okay, so which water is used for drinking and cooking? Water from lakes, rivers, ponds and wells. These waters are used, these waters can be used for cooking and drinking purpose. We can use this water for cooking and drinking. We can boil this water, okay, or we can filter this water before using it for cooking and drinking. But we cannot use sea and ocean water, okay. If we will drink this sea and ocean water, or we will, or if we use this water for cooking, what will happen? We may fall sick, okay. That impurities or that germs in the water which is present, that will go inside our body and we will fall sick. Okay. Now, see kids, when we bring, suppose if we bring water directly from the well, if the water is not cleaned, how, what we should do? We clean water in different ways, such as boiling, filtering. Boiling removes germs from water and filtering removes impurities present in water. See, before storing the water in a pot or some storing, if you have some storing vessels for water, before storing water, what you should do? You should filter the water. Okay, we should filter the water. See, can you see the picture, in the second picture, how the filtering is done? Okay, now nowadays we are having so many equipments, like so many electronic equipments for filtering water. Yes or no? We are having aqua guards, we are having filters. Yes or no? For filtering water. But in olden days, people used to, what they used to do, they used to tie a cloth around a pot and they used to filter the water. Okay, or what is the other method of cleaning the water? We can boil the water. Yes or no? You should also drink boiled water, which is good for health. Boiling kills the germ. Once we boil the water, the germs which are present in water gets, the germs which are present in water, they are killed. Okay, and the water is pure to drink. Okay, it is now clean to drink. So what you will do, if you want to store water, before storing water you have to clean the water. How you will do this? By boiling or filtering. Okay, now we should keep this useful tips in mind while handling water. See kids, now we come to know from where the water comes. From where the water comes? Water comes from rain, lakes, ponds, rivers, seas and oceans. Okay, but sea and ocean water is not useful for drinking and cooking purpose. Okay, so these are the important thing. And one more thing which we studied today is we have to clean the water by boiling or filtering it. Okay, and one more important thing which we are going to study now, that is we should keep this useful tips in mind while handling water. What are these? Let's see. What are the tips? Let's see. First is, keep drinking water covered. Okay, see, whenever we are drinking water from a pot, you take a glass full of water from a pot, immediately cover the pot. Otherwise, what will happen? Some dust or some impurities will get into that water. Okay, and that water will get contaminated. It will get dirty. The water will become dirty. Some dust may get into the water. Okay, so keep the water, keep the pot covered. Okay, keep the drinking water covered. If you are storing the water in some big utensils, keep the water covered. Okay, keep the drinking water covered. And what is the second tip? Do not store water in dirty utensils. See what they are saying? Do not store water in dirty utensils. We should always wash the utensils before storing the water. Okay, do not store water in dirty utensils. Okay, what is the next tip? Do not use dirty hands while handling water. Yes, this is very, very, very important. As soon as you are coming from play or you are coming from outside, first of all, wash your hand before drinking water. Don't put your dirty hand, inside the pot or inside the vessel in which you have stored the water. Okay? And what is the next tip? Drinking water should be stored in a clean place. Yes, always keep drinking water vessels in a clean place. Okay? You will keep these tips in mind? Yes, these are very important tips. Okay? Now, next is, water is very valuable. We should not waste water. Yes or no? Water is very valuable. We should not waste water. If someone has kept the tap open, what you will do? Go and close the tap. Don't waste water. Okay? Now, see kids, it was a very simple and small chapter. So, based on this chapter, today we are going to do a small activity. Okay? And what you will do? You will write this activity question answers in your EVS notebook. Okay? So, shall we start? Answer the following. Okay? And the first question is, where do we get water from? Where do we get water from? I already told you. Okay. Teacher will give answer to this. Okay? Answer is, we get water from many sources such as rains, lakes, rivers, ponds, wells, seas and oceans. From where we get water? We get water from many sources such as rains, lakes, rivers, ponds, wells, seas and oceans. Okay? Now we'll see the second question. Which are the two methods of cleaning water? Which are the two methods of cleaning water? Which are the two methods? Just now teacher has explained you. Yes, very good. Which are the two methods? Boiling and filtering. Very good. So, how you will write the answer for this? Let's see. The two methods of cleaning water are boiling and filtering. Okay? Which are the two methods of cleaning water? The two methods of cleaning water are boiling and filtering. Okay? Now, next question. Why do we need water? It's very important. Why do we need water? I already told you, why do we need water? Yes, we need water for drinking, bathing, washing our clothes, utensils, cooking. Yes or no? So, how you will write answer for this? Let's see. We need water for drinking, cleaning, cooking and bathing. Why do we need water? We need water for drinking, cleaning, cooking and bathing. Okay, now kids, it's very important you will write all these three question answers in your EVS notebook. Okay, on the top you will write the chapter name, that is water. Okay, and then you will give the heading answer the following and start writing all these three question answers. Okay kids, I hope you all must have understood this lesson. Okay, and please practice this question answers. Okay, I hope you all will practice. Okay kids, thank you and bye.